Welcome to an episode of Zen and the Art of Work. My name is Karash. I wanted to show you one way that I've been able to handle a large number of projects recently. Some of them had deadlines, some of them didn't, and there's no really right way to do this sort of thing, but this particular approach has worked for me, and I wanted to at least present a principle that could go behind working on multiple projects. The thing is, juggling multiple deadlines, knowing what to start and when, knowing what you'll be able to take on a few months from now, these are not simple matters. Each project you take on will likely last an unclear amount of time, and you probably have other responsibilities to take care of in the meantime. To find some degree of calm, we need to feel that we can work from, let's say, a simple set of decisions, like a short list, and then feel that that list and our system in general are supportive. We need to feel that the things we see on our list, the decisions that we can make from them, that these items are useful for now, for the present, for where we are, and that other work will stay out of our way until they're needed. One of the things we can do to help us on the way there is to plan the beginning of our projects. This is the central idea of today's video. When you do this, you can create a buffer. It gives you confidence that you'll get to something when needed, that you'll have time to be creative with it, and you'll have a relaxed pace to do your work. You can be more focused with where you decide you want your attention to be. So again, while I consider this tip itself simple, there is a certain advanced quality to it in that it rests on you having some time and task management skills. Now, specifically, these are at least that you have some trusted system, something that you can regularly review to put what you want in front of you when you want it to be there, that you can have certain projects active and set other ones aside. You can be using pen and paper. You can be using any particular system that you find to be useful for you. And of course, good systems always are developing, so I'm not saying you need something to be perfect, you just need something you're working on. Could be a daily list. You also need some way of outlining or brainstorming. That could be pen and paper if you'd like. Finally, you'll need to have some practice with what I call workflow fundamentals. These are things you may already be doing, but I'm adding a label to them here, and I'll describe them briefly in a moment. For this particular video, though, I'll be using a couple of tools. One is MindNode for outlining, and the other is OmniFocus for task management. The workflow fundamentals that I just mentioned are specifically being able to decide on a piece of work, being with that work, and then doing that regularly. These sound simple, and again, we often already do this, but as anyone who has ever procrastinated can attest to, these are not so simple. I'd say they're more practiced than they are fully mastered. Rather than be all talk, I wanted to show off a sampling of my own projects. This is roughly quarter four, 2016, extending into the beginning of 2017. Some projects I've removed, some smaller ones, some things that I just don't think should be public. Some parts I've anonymized a bit, but for the most part, this represents what I've been able to do. Some of these had deadlines, some of them didn't. Some of them are about me working on the same project, actually, during two different time spans. The thing is, if I actually looked at this timeline, I don't think I would have done the work. I'd probably have been more overwhelmed than anything else. While I was doing all of this, I wasn't overwhelmed. I was able to focus calmly. I still saw my clients. I spent time with family. I did the dishes, practiced piano, enjoyed video games. Do things that are generally good to do. Certainly, there were days of stress too, but that's more about life throwing things at me because that's what life likes to do. It wasn't, though, about a sense of inability or some dread of doing work. And it might sound like or look like that I'm showing off a bit, and you know, possibly I am. I do look at this with some excitement and say, hey, look at all the stuff I managed to do. I go me. But I also wanted to present that the ideas are not far-fetched and that you can do it too. So how did I get there from a simple list? I'll show an example of how I did this recently. So I've been in the middle of a bunch of public talks that I've needed to prepare them. The presentations are each meant to be about 1 to 3 hours, and they're effectively performances. I need to put some ideas together, some ideas I've already written, some things I haven't, and then I need to practice them too, have like an ongoing flow to the presentation, and then I need to practice them again right before the presentation so that I have the ideas fresh in mind when I'm presenting. So my general approach to working on a project is to start it early, preferably as soon as it's assigned, and then sit with it regularly. Usually I do that daily until it's done. I have a task in my system that repeats daily so that when I mark it complete, it disappears today and then appears again the next day. Smaller, non-repeating tasks, more routine clearing type things, they'll sit there too. At any one time, I tend to have about 1 to 3 of these projects going. These basically become my big rocks of the day. So more likely I have multiple repeating tasks that I touch on every day. Here's an example of how my daily list actually looks. You can see the top 3 as my ongoing projects, and I also work on music every morning regardless of what's going on. And on the day I took this screenshot, it was the weekend. So you can see my weekend task of updating and filing things on my computer too. Other projects are effectively on hold. I have a way to maybe do those tiny 2-minute or less tasks for side projects, but for the most part, these projects are set aside. The problem was that I had about 8 of these presentations to put together over the course of several months, and I also had other obligations to take care of, and I don't particularly like working on multiple presentations at once. I just feel that creatively I get my wires crossed. So maybe I'd want one of these to be the project that I was working on, while the others could be about, say, family or my psychiatric practice. So I had to figure out, how do I make sure I have enough time to do each project? I never know quite how long a project will take, and I don't know what the work landscape is going to look like on the day that I want to start either. So a few months ago, I started sketching an outline of the talks that were on my mind. This is MindNode. You can see these were just the initial talks that I was needing to prepare. I added some dates of presentations that I remembered, other ones I didn't. Just had a general idea. I still needed to talk to some people about things. And I kept fleshing out the plan. I added some titles, some dates, and eventually I had a list of all the presentations, and I just needed to start adding dates as to when to begin preparations for each one. I eventually came up with a series of potential start dates, aiming for at least a few weeks or a month beforehand. I just wanted to make sure that I was able to start something by a particular date. Again, this wasn't a due date, it was a try-to-start-by date. So now I had to add those lists of dates to when I would start the project. And maybe the simplest way to do this could be a calendar. So if you want to do that, go for it. That could work fine. Personally, I wanted to integrate it as part of OmniFocus. So I created a group of tasks under the heading Navigation. And I added defer dates to the tasks that represent each project that I needed to start by a certain time. You can see that these tasks are grayed out, which means that they're not active. I wouldn't see them in my daily list. And this particular image was taken before February 6th. When that day comes, then it becomes active, and I would see it on my daily list. I could then decide what I want to place on hold or make inactive so that I can maintain the roughly 3 maximum projects. Keeping that number steady helps me not get overwhelmed, and it's a nice solid structure that allows me to keep on course. For those of you using OmniFocus, I can briefly show you the inner workings of this. The project is Land and Sea, and I blogged about it separately, and I'll add maybe a link somewhere about how I use this. The new addition in this particular video is this top section called Navigation, which I just described. But if you have everything grouped together into a single project, you can select the project here, Land and Sea Project, then focus it using Shift-Command-F, and then use Command 4 to enter forecast mode. What that does, if you have your deferred items shown, is that you can now see your upcoming month without interference from the rest of your project library. All the while, you actually still maintain this simple list from which you can work. You can do all the planning around this, but when you want to work, you just have an easy way to do so. Certainly, there are other ways to plan ahead, but this has been nice for me. Once I had it set up, I really could just run on autopilot, sitting with the work in my daily list. The idea is the same. Plan the beginning of your projects. Now, interestingly, on several occasions, I hadn't even run into those dates I'd set. Instead, I would often finish something else first, and then I could make a presentation project active before that defer date. So right now is February, and I'm done through July. Now, that might seem that the whole exercise is fruitless, but that's not the case at all. Doing this work crucially helped me focus, because I knew that if I didn't do things at a certain pace, I would have the alerts that I needed to return to the pace that I needed. And that peace of mind made a huge difference. And I also did run into those dates on occasion, too. If you're interested in further study, I can recommend Zen and the Art of Work, Creating Flow with OmniFocus, or Workflow Mastery. Zen and the Art of Work is a video course about building a simple system, could be pen and paper if you want, starting with a single project that you choose. It could be something fun, something difficult, whatever you want. You then go through a series of single exercises at your own pace to eventually build an overarching working system for all of your projects. Then, Creating Flow with OmniFocus is about using the program OmniFocus and helps you learn task management in detail. There you can start with as many projects as you like and orchestrate things from there. Workflow Mastery is an application-independent ebook that studies productivity and meaningful work in academic depth. It's likely most useful if you already have a working system that you are looking to polish to a shine. Any of these are available at zenandtheartofwork.com or using omnifocus.com. Thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoyed this.